And yes. Hi, I'm Murray McLauchlan. Welcome to this edition of Swinging on a Star. This is a show about songs and the people who write and perform them. My guests today are Marc Jordan. And performing together, Guy Clark and Towns Van Zandt. Backing us up as usual, we got Danny Greenspoon on the guitar. Mr. Kit Johnson on the bass. And guesting in on violin, the redoubtable Joel Zifkin. We hope you enjoy this episode. Stay with us. Try to drive the producer nuts with that one. You see, this is the musical theory that it's only a mistake if everybody doesn't do it at the same time. So we've been testing out this theory with various musical variations. Some of them really stink. I think that was a pretty good example. I wrote this particular song some time ago, about 5 or 6 years ago, I guess. Maybe even more now. But it was really all wrapped up in this one idea. Kind of Japanese in its origin. This one little idea that if the wind could blow my troubles away, I wish it would get stronger. So this is what it wound up being like. When I recorded this song, a producer named Bob Ezrin did the record that it was on. Who was better known for doing like Alice Cooper and Peter Gabriel and some real stiffs like The Babies. Well, my record stiffed, it blew a big hole in the water. And this song wound up on the record sounding like it had been produced by Leo Tolstoy. Cavalry's charging and screaming kids all over the place, all kinds of stuff. But it started out being a pretty simple song. And that's how we're gonna do it for you.
Troubles away, I would stand in a hurricane, get washed away in the driving rain. If the wind could blow my troubles away, blow my troubles away. If the wind could blow my troubles away, tear the sadness from my face, I'd look in the mirror and I wouldn't see a trace. If the wind could blow my troubles away, blow my troubles away. Blow my troubles away. See me stand with a smiling face, clothes on flapping all over the place. If the wind could blow my troubles away, blow my troubles away. Thank you. my troubles away. I would stand in a hurricane, get washed away in the driving rain, if the wind could blow my troubles away, blow my troubles away. Troubles away. I would stand in a hurricane, get washed away in the driving rain, if the wind could blow my troubles away, could blow all my troubles away.
I'm real happy to welcome back to Swingin' on a Star the redoubtable, the lovely and charming Mr. Guy Clark, who has come with his touring buddy now, Towns Van Zandt. So welcome to both of you. It's really nice to have you on.
Thank you.
Is there a thing about, you know, guys from Texas that are like, are they all real deadpan?
It's the water, the drinking water.
Is it? No, you're both like that. You're real kind of serious-looking guys until you actually smile or something.
Well.
Is this song you're going to do actually is about Ramblin' Jack Elliott?
Yeah, it is.
Are you going to tell horrible Ramblin' Jack Elliott story?
No, I'm just going to explain the song, how it came about, which was about a year and a half ago. I was down in Austin, Texas for Jerry Jeff Walker's birthday bash. And we got bashed, and we bashed, and we had a big time. I ran into these couple of Yahoo friends of mine, one named Ramblin' Jack Elliott, who, if any of y'all know, you know they don't call him Ramblin' Jack because he travels around a lot. Never heard Jack tell a story. And this other guy is maybe the world's best rodeo cowboy that ever lived. His name is Larry Mahan. And the three of us decided, well, I don't know if we decided, but we certainly proceeded to stay up all night and greet the dawn in Austin, Texas. So Ramblin' Jack said, I got these lines in my face, trying to straighten out the wrinkles in my life. When I think of all the fools I've been, it's a wonder that I've sailed this many miles. To which Mahan replied, he said, the sweet bird of youth was sitting on my shoulder yesterday, but she's always changing partners, and I always knew she'd up and fly away. Staying up all night in a Driscoll hotel, and Ramblin' Jack and Mahan was cowboyed all to hell. And the room smelled like bulls, and the words sounded like songs. Now there's a pair to draw, two boys I would not steer you wrong. Jack said, I recall the time that I set my soul on fire just for show. And all it ever taught me was the more I learned, the less I seemed to know. Mahan crawled out from behind the couch, said, "Jack." He said, "As far as I can see, mistakes are only horses in disguise. There ain't no need to ride them over, cause we could not ride them different if we tried. Miss staying up all night in a Driscoll hotel, Ramblin' Jack and Mahan, this cowboyed all the hell. And the room smelled like bulls, and the words sounded like songs. Now there's a pair to draw, two boys I would not steer you wrong, yeah. Staying up all night in a Driscoll hotel, Ramblin' Jack and Mahan, this cowboyed all the hell. And the room smelled like bulls, words sound like songs. Now there's a pair to draw, two boys I would not steer you wrong."
You know, Guy, I was looking over your list of cuts, and it's awfully impressive, as is Towns. But you have the singular honor of being the only person that I've ever encountered who had a song cut by Slim Pickens.
Hey, listen, man, that's my favorite thing I've ever had cut. He read Desperado's Waiting for a Train as a poem over the music.
Sort of the way Walter Brennan used to do Superstition Mountain?
Uh-huh, only a lot cooler.
Really? Wow, what a milestone.
Yeah, really.
Now, a song that Towns Van Zandt's going to do is, I don't know if they get more well-known than this really now, but it's...
Well, it did really well. It's a pretty song.
It's certainly one of the best-known cuts that Waylon and Willie ever did anyway. Nice video, too.
Willie and Merle.
Oh, what did I say? Willie and Merle, but I said Waylon and Willie, because the thing.
It's a good song. I have a true story about how it's Pancho and Lefty we're talking about. Want to hear a true story? This is true. I've told it a million times, but it's true, so it can't hurt.
You know. It's truer every day.
It's truer every day. But anyway, I was traveling with this friend of mine named Daniel, and because he had a car. And I had a three-day job in playing in Dallas, Texas. And just so happens that during the same 3 days, Billy Graham and the Guru Maharaji both had three-day jobs in Dallas. And Billy Graham drew like 500,000 young Christians from all over the world. You know, he played at Texas Stadium. And the Guru played at the Dallas Coliseum. And he drew about 250,000 young gurus from all over the world. And I played downtown. I drew about 9 winos from Houston. But because of all this newfound religiosity in Dallas, there was not a hotel room to be found for 60-mile diameter. So my friend Daniel and I take off, and we drive north, and we finally find a place that has no TV, zero TV. Coke machine's been broken for, you know, since the owner's wife left him, which is probably 1935. And there was a big hole in the swimming pool, and nothing to do, so... I sat down one about the second day and decided, this is no good. I'm going to sit right here in this chair until I write some kind of a song, any old song, with a start and a middle and a finish. And I sat there and I sat there and I sat there. And it felt like the first lines of Pancho and Lefty just kind of drifted through the window like it, you know, feels that way sometimes. And the Guru and Billy Graham, you know, kind of co-wrote this song, but I never heard anything from them. keep you free and clean. Now you wear your skin like iron, your breath's as hard as kerosene. You want your mama's only boy, but her favorite one it seems. She began to cry when you said goodbye, sank into your dreams. Pancho's a bandit boy, his horse was fast as polished steel. Wore his gun outside his pants for all the honest world to feel. Pancho met his match, you know, on the deserts down in Mexico. And nobody heard his dying words. Oh, but that's the way it goes. All the federales say they could have had him any day. They only let him hang around out of kindness, I suppose. Lefty, he can't sing the blues all night long like he used to. Dust and Pancho bit down south, named it up in Lefty's mouth. The day they laid poor Pancho low, Lefty slipped for Ohio, where he got the bread to go. But ain't nobody know. All the federales say they could have had him any day. Only let him hang around out of kindness, I tell how Pancho fell. Lefty's living in a cheap hotel. The desert's quiet and Cleveland's cold. So the story ends, we're told. Pancho needs your prayers, it's true. Save a few for Lefty too. He just did what he had to do. Oh, now he's growing old. Great federales say they could have had him any day. Only let him go so wrong out of kindness, I suppose. A few great federales say they could have had him any day. Only let him go so wrong out of kindness, I suppose.
Thanks, everybody.
Towns Van Zandt. Immediately preceded by Guy Clark. I'm very pleased to welcome to Swingin' on the Star, Marc Jordan. Marc's, I guess, it's interesting because we don't have that many writers on the show. Really only one other, which was Eddie Schwartz, who exclusively, at least in your case for the last 12 years, I reckon, have made their living exclusively as a writer.
Because nobody will hire me to sing anywhere except you, Murray.
Did you get enough? Well, you're on in, you know, your latest cut, the Rod Stewart cut, which you're going to do later, is a whopping big hit, so that must feel awful good.
It does. It
vindicates the lifestyle, anyway.
It does. I've been living beyond my means for too many years.
Well, you've been hungry to do a little live performing now. I mean, you're the only guy I know who moved to Los Angeles that says he wants to come back to Toronto.
Right. I moved there, I moved there in 1980, so it's 11 years, and... Yeah, it feels like it's time to come back.
What's the first thing you're going to do for us? It's actually one of your quite well-known songs, isn't it?
This is an old song, and it's about an area just south of Los Angeles on the coast. It's kind of a Disneyland version of the American dream, full of perfect people. And it was a part of it was actually designed by Howard Hughes, so you can imagine what a wacky place it is. It's called Marina Del Ray. 1, 2, 3, 4.
With no story, living on the edge of history, lying face up in the sand, brown body, can't see his dream dying. I'm living in Marina Del Rey. Man, you better get a job. I'm living off the sun and the sea in Marina Del Rey. Come here from the clover to dream and drown and make money. Drawn to the land of plenty, baby, that's all over. Drinking Coca-Cola, writing the names in the sand. I smoke this shit, made me paranoid. Yes, I'm living in Marina Del Rey. Man, you better get a job. I'm living off the sun and the sea in Marina Del Rey.
You've got a pretty recent release out on BMG, that Cal album. I mean, this 12 years of not going out and playing live, I mean, you've obviously got ample opportunity to do so if you want to, so this is obviously
a choice. I just was in the studio for 10 years. It's kind of a lost decade for me. I don't know where the hell it went. And then I just feel like I want to get out and be in front of people again.
Yeah, well, we were talking before. You were saying something to the effect of, anyway, that if you don't get a chance to take song out in front of people, I don't know how you put it exactly, but you lose your sense of
caught up with the machines. The recording is so much technology now, and you can just sit in front of these computers and wail away and try to make music, but you really don't know whether it's any good until you get out and play it in front of people.
Like your own emotional kickback on it just isn't enough to figure that out.
Sometimes it is. I mean, sometimes you guess and it's a good song. But when you get out and play in front of people, you know in four bars whether the song is good or not, because you can just see it on people's faces.
Well, speaking of good, I kind of like this next one that you were going to do.
This is another
I like one. Anything with the void dancing. It's yeah, always nice know. Because I like diameter.
You're a good dancer. That's
dancer,
why.
Actually.
This is called Dancing on the Boardwalk.
Maggie never wore her longest around here no more. She cut her hair, her mother's joy, and became a ne'er-do-well. And her old friends on the block became the object of some talk between the local cop and the lady in Stepper's Hall. But sometimes her and sometimes me get the feeling where we had a moment free. You could always catch some talk. Jukebox began to rock. We were singing, yeah, dancing on the boardwalk. Ooh, our feet would never stop. The word became so hot. We were singing, yeah, dancing on the boardwalk. The sun, as I remember, was a huge red ball in the Brooklyn sky. He'd be right through our bodies as it silhouetted you and I. A downtown kid crouched in a doorway like a tiger in an alley cat's eye, waiting for the sunset like moonlight. But sometimes her, sometimes her, get the feeling when we have always catch some talk. As the jukebox began to rock, we were singing, yeah, dancing on the boardwalk. Ooh, our feet would never stop. When we came so hot, we were singing, yeah. Cut her hair, her mother's joy, and became a ne'er-do-well. Her old friends on the block became the object of some talk between the local cops and the ladies' temperance hall. But sometimes her, and sometimes me, where we had a moment free. You could always catch some talk. As the jukebox began to rock, we were singing, yeah, dancing on the boardwalk. Ooh, our feet would never stop. When we came so hot, we were singing. On the boardwalk. Ooh, our feet would never
We were singing, yeah, dancing on the boardwalk. Sometimes her, sometimes me. Get the feeling when we had a moment free.
Yeah. Marc Jordan.
Thank you.
We'll get Joel to fire up the fiddle here. I don't know what to say about this particular song. It's certainly one of the more bloodthirsty things that I ever wrote. It's about a guy, and I invented the guy because at the time I was having some romantic difficulties, and I sort of invented this guy in order to vent an enormous amount of rage. So he's loosely based on myself. I killed him off at the end of the song. This guy was so stupid in this song. He thought he'd fallen in love with this person and absolutely missed the boat, just sort of fell in love with some silly idea of what it was that he thought she was. And was so self-centered and so dumb that he goes to his own death at the end of the song thinking of nothing but himself. That's the good thing about being a songwriter, is you get to kick yourself in the ass and still have a sense of humor about it. It's called Bobby and Caroline.
Bobby loved Caroline. So much he was blind, but she had somebody she was seeing on the side. And his friends, they said nothing, though most of them knew. He just saw in her what he wanted to. Caroline, she wasn't bad, she didn't mean no harm. She was out for a good time, she was still too young. And Bobby's kind of love made the walls close in, made all her tomorrows like they're gonna be the same. One night Bobby was driving to the jug milk store. He drove past the Ramada Inn, and there by the door stood Caroline, the love of his life. And a stranger was with her, he was holding her tight. Said she was going to a movie with her friends. He watched them go up to the desk and check in. Then he stomped on the gas and the tires smoked and screamed. And his brain turned to fire as it shattered his dreams. Bobby's car hit itself across a county line. He was gonna find somebody, take revenge on Caroline. He would let that hot whiskey make some sense out of his life. And the dashboard needle read 75. There was a blind curve, Bobby was flying. It was way too fast, and he held a straight line. And the metal tore, and the glass went flying, till the wreck lay quiet with Bobby inside. Break it down. Thank you.
he died in the dark by the road. Cried for Caroline, 'cause she's never gonna know it was her that had sent him out to die like this, with the name Caroline and a curse upon his lips. One, two, three.
Thank you. He said, don't do the curse. Kid had this thing worked out in rehearsals when he said, and a curse upon his lips he was going to do. May the fleas of 1,000 camels infest your beard. Have you got your handy dandy 17 seconds all put together?
Hi. You're listening to Swinging on a Star.
CBC Radio.
And CBC Stereo.
My guest today, I'm Marc Jordan, Guy Clark, and Towns Van Zandt. Where did I put that? No dose. Must be in the glove box here somewhere. I don't know. Ben brought it in park. I wonder what's on the radio.
We're back with Guy Clark, who's here as part of the touring duo of Guy Clark and Towns Van Zandt this particular time. I'm going to ask, I guess, both of you collectively and individually, there's some real special thing about Texas. There's an enormous music scene there. It's enormously glamorous. So many good people, from blues rockers, you know, the Johnny Edgar winter days, all the way to now, to country writers. What the heck is it about the place that
it's
generates that?
We told you already.
I take it back about the deadpan.
We've been asked that. I've been asked that a lot. Guy and I travel together about a third of the time, I guess. We have the same booking agent, and we've been friends for 25 years.
Well, it seems like most of the people that I have met who are from the scene in Texas have an inclination to like to help each other out and support each other rather than assume that anybody in the world that's making a dollar is taking it away from them.
Well,
there seems to be an attitude. Like Jerry Jeff was a great help to you in the early days.
Sure. Jerry's great. I mean, he helped a lot.
I watched him once I couldn't do anything about it, but I watched him get thrown down 3 flights of stairs by some bouncers in a bar in Yonge Street once.
Well,
I was always amazed he could still play after that. So what is the next song about, guys?
It's about throwing 3 bouncers down the stairs. It's a real pretty song called Better Days. It's one of my favorite.
Well, she's standing at the window, her face to the glass. As far as she can see, the time has come to pass. Oh, as far as she can see, the sky is all ablaze. This looks like the first of better days. She's taking charge of her life for a change. She's taking it back that she's lost. It's just as clear as the window pane. She'll survive at all costs. Thank you. I'll see the wings unfolding that weren't there just before. She has no fear of flying, and now she's out the door. Out into the morning light, where the sky is all ablaze. This looks like the first of better days. She's taking charge of her life for a change. She's taking it back that she's lost. It's just as clear as the window. She'll survive at all cost. She's taking charge of her life. She's taking it back that she's lost. It's just as clear as the window pane. She'll survive at all.
Here we are back with Marc Jordan. I was reading some information about you, that there was a deal that went down where, like the act loved the song, but the BBC wouldn't play it because it had content about the war while they were busy having one.
Yeah. That was...
What kind of flack went down? What happened?
It was so weird because I wrote this song called Rhythm of My Heart in 1983, and it's basically an anti-war song. It's about a soldier coming back from war. And funnily enough, after all these years, Rod Stewart heard it and wanted to record it, and it became his first single. And just as they were going to put it out, I guess his managers or somebody in England sent it, promotional copies to the BBC. And they said, and it was right at the time of the Persian Gulf War. That was in January, I guess. They said, "Oh, we can't play this because there's references to war," and nobody could really understand. They wanted a rewrite, and so they sent it back to me, and I didn't want to do a rewrite, and it was already recorded. And luckily, the war ended. It was a short one, boy. But so it seemed so bizarre to me that they were actually over there bombing people, and. Yet they wouldn't play an anti-war.
They didn't necessarily want anybody to think that was a bad idea.
I guess. I guess. It floored me. It really did.
Gee, well, I guess you're probably the first guy in the States who bought that Norman Schwarzkopf video then. Thanks, Norm.
Dancing
Thanks
with Paula.
Lot, yeah. Oh, cool. No, I mean, that was the thing that blew me away. It was like the BBC's like... I thought that'd be like the last place in the world that would ever sort of come.
I thought maybe like I thought there would be problems in the States before there would be in England, but I don't know. It must be a very conservative.
Well, maybe parliamentary democracy isn't all it's all it used to be.
No,
it's not like it is here.
BBC isn't all it used to be.
So are you going to mosey to the piano?
Yeah.
Did I really say that? Oh no. Well, again, it's one of those things. I got to stop using that word.
Mosey to the piano?
Yeah. Sashay over to the piano.
Well, thank you. See, what people in Radioland don't understand is that I'm wearing a lovely gown this evening. With some pumps and a few other items of clothing.
Thank you. across the street, the river runs down in the gutter. Life is slipping away. Let me still exist in another place, burning undercover of a helicopter blade. The flames are getting higher in effigy, burning down the bridges of my memory. Love may still be alive somewhere, some way, where they're down and only dear 100 steel pounds away. Oh, the rhythm of my heart has been like a drum, and the words of love you rolling off my tongue. Oh, never will I roam, 'cause I know my place is home. Where the ocean meets the sky, I'll be staying. Photographs and kerosene, brighten up the darkness, light it up, light it up. I can still feel the touch of your thin blue jeans, running down the alley. I got my eyes all over you, baby, yeah. Oh, the rhythm of my heart is beating like a drum, and the words of love you're rolling off my tongue. I never will I roam, 'cause I know my place is home. Where the ocean meets the sky, I'll be staying. Veins dripping like the handle on a slide machine. Love may still exist in another place. I'm just yanking back the hammer, no expression on my face. Oh, the rhythm of my heart is beating like a drum. Oh, never will I roam, 'cause I know my place is home. Where the ocean meets the sky, I'll be staying. Oh, the rhythm of my heart is beating like a drum, and the words I love you rolling off my tongue. Oh, never will I roam, 'cause I know my place is home. Where the ocean meets the sky, I'll be staying.
Marc Jordan.
Thank you.
Mistakes and all.
That wraps today's edition of Swingin' on a Star. Many thanks to my guests, Marc Jordan, to Guy Clark, and Towns Van Zandt. As usual, thanks to Danny Greenspoon on the guitar and Kit Johnson on the bass, and special thanks to Joel Zifkin on violin for sitting in today. Us next week, when our show will be a special tribute to Wade Hemsworth. Wade will be here and stars Kate and Anna McGarrigle and a cast of millions. I'm Murray McLauchlan, and we'll see you next week for Swingin' on a Star.